Hello dears, myself Dr. Lata Sharma is now with you with a new topic and the BPSC 141 Gandhian ideology, Gandhian philosophy related to this topic. Today is a very important topic as we have to know, as you are aware about that we are with you with all of the topics that related to IGNU, that is related to BAG, BPSC 141. So, this is the timing that we have to start with the Gandhian philosophy in peace and harmony. Gandhian philosophy in peace and harmony. This is a new topic, and now be with me at this topic. This will be useful for you, and I think that you are getting very, very important topics. And I am noticing that you are getting all of the beautiful, important topics that is related to your syllabus and that is related to your all of the topics. So now start with this, that is Gandhian philosophy in peace and harmony. As we are aware that Gandhian philosophy is related to that what they want. Their ideology is totally depend on what we have to do. We can say that this is really a very logical and very ethical aspect. If we say that ethics is more important for becoming a citizen, so they have focused in all of their life that you have to be ethics, you have to follow the ethics, so everything will be easily followed by you, because ethics tell us how we have to maintain our citizenship, our as like a human. This is the humanity they have given us in a very important, that is named in ideology. So this is, if we say that their ideology is related to the universe and related to the humankind, so this is really okay, and this is really yes. So this is here that the Gandhiji has given an important aspect about the humanity, about the peace, about the life and about the mankind. So this is, global peace has become a major concern these days. We are now discussing about that what has happened today and what the Gandhiji's Gandhian ideology related to peace and harmony, what they have done and for what they have to be do. So this is the thing that we have to be cautious about, what Gandhiji has given, what the Gandhiji they want to tell us about their ideology and about their opinion and about their thinkings. So this is the timings that we are now facing, that is global peace have become a major concern these days. In the present time, humanity is facing a terrible challenge of its own existence. There is a general restlessness in the entire world, which is leading to widespread violence. If we say that this is the timing that we are, at that timing, the humanity is facing a very important and very terrible challenges. That is, for what? For its existence. This is the main thing, that existence is necessary for making the humankind alive. So global peace is the only way that by that they can exist on this earth. So we can say there is a general restlessness. This is the world here that everybody is feeling not comfortable, not peaceful, not in a humanitarian aspect. So this is the type of restlessness that is related to that what we have done, what we have done before that, and what now, where I have standing, where I have made the space. This is restlessness in the entire world. We will discuss that what is the reason of restlessness in the entire world, which is leading to widespread violence. This is the main reason that what we have done, we have made the violence. We have done, we have support, we have given the advice of violence, and we support that violence because we want our existence. This is existence. That is the reason why we want our existence, because there is a terrible challenge everybody is facing as an humanity, we can say. So this is the widespread aspect of violence. Today, communal amity has become essential for national integration, and hence Gandhi gave it the highest priority. This is national integration. What should be the communal unity has become essential for national integration. That is unity and the national integration. That is Gandhiji gave it to the highest priority. this is thing that what they want, that we are discussing about the global peace and we are discussing about the Gandhian philosophy in peace and harmony. So what they want, main thing is there, that what they want, national integration, unity, and this is the thing that Gandhiji has given it into a highest priority. This is the thing that they doesn't want the restless. This is the reason that the restlessness in the entire world due to violence, that due to that there is no integration. Everybody wants their sphere, their area, their field, their property. So this is restlessness is okay here, there, because when there is a no peace in the mind, anybody cannot become the peaceful person. So humanity is that everybody enjoy the facilities of the nature that the nature has given to us. So but what is happening here, that is not nature. We have not keep our promise related to nature. So this is the highest priority what we have given there, national integration, and this is the communal unity is important here. We can say that what is the need of Gandhian philosophy? This is the thing, that is there any requirement of Gandhian philosophy here? Why there is a requirement of Gandhian philosophy? What has happened here that we also demand for the Gandhian philosophy? Is we have done something wrong that we have to make over, we have to start, we have to think again for the Gandhian philosophy? Otherwise, this is the thing that we have got into the freedom by our freedom fighter. These are the many questions that raise around the Gandhian philosophy, that what we have done. We can say that especially today, even when we are surrounded by the forces of darkness, we need a leader like Gandhi. Yes, we can say this is really, if you think the side of darkness, the forces of darkness, that what type of darkness is here. So we think that we need a leader also here. Now, a man of rare courage, character and charisma, who dares to tell the truth. As usual, to my dear student, what we have to do for that, and Gandhiji what want? As we say that this person is a very rare courage, and his character is overall very stipulated and very important character and charisma, who dares to tell the truth? Who can overcome violence with non-violence, and who shows us the way of light? This is thing that who shows us the way of light. Therefore, Gandhian philosophy and thoughts are relevant in the changing world of today and can help in difficult times. And the philosophy is also needed for global peace. Is there the main thing is there that what is the type of personality Gandhi was, and what they have given to us? They have a very important character. What is the main thing that they always make a truth? Who never dares to tell the truth? Who can overcome violence with non-violence? If we say that if a person is not aware about the Gandhian philosophy, so he will not be aware. He has not to be capable to explain about the Gandhi. If we go accordingly to the timings, to the surrounding, to the which timing they have struggled according to British timings and the slavery timings, and we have not got the freedom, what the efforts they have done, we can't say that these efforts, you know, this is the total philosophy they have given in their efforts. So these are the Gandhian philosophy and thoughts are relevant in the changing world of today. Now it is also happening that we are also feeling that their thoughts, their ideology, their opinions, their thinkings are relevant in the changing world of today and can help in difficult times. And the philosophy is also needed for global peace. What is required here, that this philosophy, what type of philosophy, for making the truth to the non-violence and becoming the torch bearer and becoming the leader, and there is a very important character, personality is there. So these are the timing that their philosophy, their personality is also needed for global peace, because when Indian ideology is there, covered by the thinking and outlook by the Gandhiji. We think about Vasudev Kutumbakam. We think about that Ahimsa Parmo Dharma. So there is the thing we have given in our slogans, in our ideologies, that this is the thing that we want: global peace, not any type of struggle, not any type of violence. So this is also needed for global peace. Gandhian philosophy about peace. This is here because if we say that is the demand of the time, yes, this is really a demand of the time at the timings of Gandhiji, because what was happening at the time, that every type of personality, every country, as like we can say the England, and this is all type of Britishers, they want to overcome all of the countries by making the trade, by making many type of trade and businesses to all of the countries. So this is type of, we can say, they want to overcome. So Gandhi's philosophy, what they think, that any person, any country has no right to make the colony, to make the colonial pressure to any other country, because every country has a right to live. So this is the thing, that then every country remain in their zones. They will not struggle for making the violence. They will not struggle for the countries overcome, for the, that they want to make a right upon the personalities, upon the humankind of any of other country. This thing will create a thing that they and we all wants peace. So then Mahatma Gandhi believed about the universality of religion can best be realized through the universalization of education. What will happen here? Because of, we say, yes, this is a really important thing, a really great aspect, that we have to think that universalization of education. If we say that if Indians have faces the slavery, they have not got the freedom, they have bear the tortures, they have faces many difficulties because of they were not educated. Because what education gives? Education gives to think, to live. What type of living we want? What we have to think? What we have to do? We begin to start thinking for the nation, for the society, for the countries, for the humankind. This is the thing the education gives us, and we build up the nation. If a person is educated, he build the nation. So this is all thing that they want. Peace is also related with the education. These are the thing that education, universalization of education is a very important thing, because after education we got our rights, we can also make the justice, we can also make the person who can do anything. We realize, we understand, we read ourselves after taking the education. So this is the thing, that universalization of education is the important tool for getting the peace. So this is universality of religion can best be realized through the universalization of education. Because when we become the educated, we doesn't think about anything. We think about the nation. Our first priority is nation, because we have to be aware, we become aware about the education, that what is the most important thing is in the nation, that is our nation. And that such universalization is the springboard for nation integration. After getting the universalization of education, what will happen? That there build a nation, and that what we forced to? We forced to become the national integration. He and his followers, through the King of England and his great armies out of India, using weapons of truth and non-violence. Yes, this is really very important, very tough work that the Gandhiji has done. Because if we say there are many and many persons, many personalities and many leaders were there at the timing of Gandhiji, what they have done? He and his followers through the King of England and his great armies, what they have done? They through the kingdom of England and their great and great armies out of India. If we say that time England has overcome all of the world and he has make all over the world their colony. So we are not capable in education, in we are not too much highly statused person. I am asking about India. As we can say that England is very much developed at that time and India is just like an infant in front of me, him. So England and his king, this is really tough for them. This is, they have through the King of England and his great armies out of India. What were the weapons they have used? This is truth and non-violence. My dear students, this is really, we are saying, but when we make the practice of all these things, truth and non-violence, we can say that we have to speak truth. We can do this, but if somebody is making the violence, what will happen? That we have to, we also become and favor the violence. But there is a difference about us and Gandhiji that they favor the non-violence. And they've not favored, they have done in practice. This is non-violence. If somebody is beating, they have not created the violence also. So this is the thing that Gandhian philosophy about peace, because peace is simply a word, not a word. It is a total activities related to that war, by which capacity, by which system, by which thing, activities we can favor the peace. So all of these things, that education, that national integration, that is the for making the right of their country, and what by which weapon they have given the freedom. So this is the thing, that the peace is overall a very important ideology by which Gandhiji has given us a very important life. Gandhian thought, according to Gandhi's, the universal human value of Ahimsa ought to be cultivated not merely at personal level, but at social, national and international level too. What they think about that? Truth and non-violence. They have been the weapons of truth and non-violence. So this is Gandhian thoughts according to Gandhi. This is universal human value. What they favor? That universal human value of Ahimsa. They favor the Ahimsa. What is Ahimsa? Paramo Dharma. What is the meaning of this? That we believe that our religion is Ahimsa. Ahimsa is, we have not to make the Hinsa. This is, we have not to favor the violence. We have to be non-violent. Universal human value of Ahimsa ought to be cultivated not merely at personal level, but at social, national, international level. Yes. What is happening here? They doesn't want that that should be cultivated in the personal as like only one person. They want, what they want, that it should be at a social level, it should be at a national level and international level. Because by this levels, this Ahimsa has got their place, status, and after getting in a force, this Ahimsa has given the work, this Ahimsa has done the work, as the petitioners has given us the freedom. It is a very powerful means to avoid conflict. What is the meaning of that? That very powerful means to avoid conflict, since it springs from inner realization of the equality of all human beings. The real meaning and the powerful meaning, we can say, we have to avoid the conflicts. Simple is there. Main thing what we have to do for making the non-violent, that is avoid conflict. Since it springs from inner realization of the equality of all human beings, Helium thought, acted and inspired by the vision of humanity and evolving towards a world of peace and harmony. What is there? That the Gandhiji has lived a thought. They have started to make the opinion. Their opinion has converted into thought. What they have done? They have acted their thought in real and inspired by the vision of humanity. They have think about the humanity only. This is the vision of humanity. What the thing, what on which point they have to give the focus, that is vision of a humanity evolving towards a world of peace and harmony. This is evolving towards a world of peace and harmony. Peace and harmony, they want that the humanity believe in all of these things. So they lived a thought, they acted a thought, they inspired a thought, and they make it the vision for the humanity. And for this humanity world, humanity has works towards a world of peace and humanity. Peace and Gandhian philosophy, this is what they think. If the peace can be brought up according to Gandhian philosophy, what will happen? That first is there, that is absence of war. This is the really very much true, that if nobody, no country will make a conflict with each other, that will happen, that absence of war will happen here. Sense of inner peace and well-being. Inner peace will build up. And what will we will think about? That we have to become the well-being. We will think about the well of the persons. Sense of tranquility. Harmonious relationship. What will happen if the peace building will be there? Gandhian philosophy. Harmonious relationship will build up with every country, with our person, within society, within nation level. This is the thing that we will make a harmonious relationship. As this, these all of the things that the Gandhian philosophy has given a birth to, the that if there will be no conflict with each other, that any type of absence of war, absence of struggle, absence of fight, absence of conflict will be there. Sense of inner peace and well-being. What type of sense we will start? We have to think about that is inner peace and harmonious relationship with each other, between all type of humanity. Balance in nature, ecological system. There is what will happen? Balance in nature will start. Forgiving the nature. Yes, there is a starting of thing that if there is a peace of, according to Gandhian philosophy, there should be a forgiving the nature. Working for social justice, human rights and poverty. We have to, by all these things, we will start to work for the social justice, for the human rights and for the poverty also. So all of these things will give a beautiful nation, beautiful world, beautiful earth and this sky. Forgetting all these things, that is peace. Peace is a very important phenomena for making the overall scenario clean and calm. So what will happen if we get the peace accordingly? There is absence of war, will it start? Sense of inner peace, sense of well-being, sense of tranquility, harmonious relationships, balance in nature. What will happen? Ecological, because when we think about everything, that will balance in nature, because nature is also with us. Forgiving nature. We have not to make a culprit to anybody that he has done this, he has wrong in this factor, and this country has given us such type of cheese. So this is thing to be covered here, that we have to be we are discussing about in all our senses here, that is for giving nature. Working for social justice. Our phenomena, our thinking, our lifestyle will be start, we start in a sense of that we have to make the justice in all of the vectors related to getting the human rights, related to getting the that why the poverty is here too much. So we will work on that platforms for getting result for the social justice, for the human rights and for the poverty. So this is the thing that if we say that Gandhiji has not become at the first day the international personality and they have not made the internationally peace at the first day, what they have done? They have done the little bit of workings that is related to justice, that is related to rights and that is related to poverty. So start from the starting. Start for the simple person that he has not got the right. So do for the favor, for getting, for giving him right, that what type of right he has to got, the human rights. And we have to helpful, we have to be harmonious relationship, because if there is a relationship that is harmonious, we can be able to overcome all type of these poverty and all type of struggles or all type of terrible darkness. This is related to Gandhian philosophy, that Gandhian philosophy, peace can be given, peace can be described. This is here that according to Gandhiji, if we think that values, what type of values they have given, my dear students, these are the things that is related to our, we can say, sanskars. But they have given that factors in our values, and these values work everywhere. If we can say values is our life, so there is no any too much that, because values work in all of the factors, in all of the life spheres. What type of values is there? That is truth. Simple is here. Truth is the important value in life. Non-violence, humility, forgiveness, tolerance, love, fairness, unselfishness are meant for the peace. Yes, if we think that we have to make our personality as a valuable personality, we have to favor the truth. We have to make the personalize yourself, that every time we have to speak the truth, non-violence, humility, forgiveness. What type of forgiveness is here? That is, we have to be kind and honest to everyone. Tolerance. This is the favor of non-violent. We have to be caring and loving to each other. Fairness, unselfishness. This is the thing, unselfishness. It means that you are going to help to everybody, the army for the peace. Prosperity and harmony of the world. If we do all these things, we will start a beautiful country, beautiful nation, beautiful globally peace, globally prosperity and harmony of the world. If human values are not there, we say that if the human values are not there, humanity will be destroyed. Yes, there is really a very great statement is here, that according to Gandhi, if values are not there, we are discussing about the values. What type of values? Truth, non-violence, humility, forgiveness, tolerance. These are our values. Love, fairness, unselfishness. If these are not in our life, humanity will be destroyed. Gandhi's philosophy of non-violence has found expression in other movements around the world. The Gandhian philosophy that includes ideas such as those above is certainly relevant today. Peace and Gandhian philosophy. these are the philosophies that include Kant ideas such as those above is certainly relevant today. If we say that certainly these ideas relevant today, have importance today, we can say yes, because these all values work every time, every place, every time of that we can be developed, we can be developing countries, and we have a think, we have a humanitarian aspect, because the Gandhian philosophy is not a ideology, but it exists in our lives. Because if you think about that, if a person doesn't speak truth, as there are many examples that they have not treated a very gentleman personality. If a person is unselfishness, selfish, what we think about him? If a country is selfish, what we think about him? There is no tolerance, what we think about? There are many examples there. There is no tolerance, there is like China. There is no fairness, there is Pakistan. There is no lovingness, there is also many countries are there. Unselfishness is there, selfishness is there, that we have to think that everything is start with us. So we doesn't think that these values are only depend on the person to person, but it depend on the country to country. So this is a certainly relevant today. This is all of the values that Gandhiji has given to us. Gandhiji and other believes India should have its freedom and get rid of the English rulers and their army. If we say that Gandhiji has got the change in his life after 46 to 47 years, when he was 46 to 47 years old, what they have think about that? They were in Africa and they have think about that. There is, why is there is a differences? Why there is not a justice? Why black and white? Why not everybody is human? Why everybody is selfish? There is a question mark is there, and he wants that these question marks should be deleted. So they work on that. What they work that they believe, because when he comes in India, he thinks, he see that what is happening with the humans, with the humanity, what is happening with the Indians. So they start for getting the freedom, they start for giving them justice, they start for giving them the right, they start working and get rid of English ruler and their army. My dear students, this is really not very easy task they have done. The English rulers, if we see that that time of English rulers, because now there is a very, very important organization is working for the rights, for the humanity, for the human rights. At that time, when they we have not got the freedom, there is no any type of UNO. There is nobody is there for making the help of the becoming aware of the rights. So this is the thing that India have its freedom and get rid of English rulers and their army. They have done by their workings. So he taught his people that to fight back at the English, but not with guns or other weapons. There is a promise also has to be taken that we have to fight with the English persons, but not with the guns. If we say that this is the thing that by which weapons we can fight, but they have given no, not with the guns or other weapons. Gandhi's ideas of non-violent protest or trying to change unfair practices or laws without hurting anyone have been used by important leaders in our country and around the world. This is the thing that they have fever. For the non-violent protest, they change the unfair practices, laws, that everybody hurting to everybody. Why? So they used by important, this philosophy has been used by the important leaders who were fighting for the country, who were fighting for the struggle, for the getting the freedom for the country and around to the world. Because India is not alone the colony at that time. There are many and many countries has been becoming the colony of the European countries. So this is the thing that we have gave a message to all of the persons of the humanity that nobody can rule upon any country, upon any person. Slavery will not be a justification. What the forgetting the peace and what Gandhiji have done. Gandhiji left many valuable sayings for the modern man to fight for goodness in society in non-violent way. They have given the valuable sayings to modern man that fight for goodness in society in non-violent way. The force of power never wins against the power of love. This is a statement that force of power never wins against the power of love. There can be no democracy where there is no harmony, no peace. Mahatma Gandhi taught us that we can bring harmony to our world by becoming champions of love and peace for all. Yes, really very important aspect is here that we can bring harmony to our world by becoming champions of love and peace for all. Because what we have to do? We have to become the champions in which area? In the love and affection, in the love and peace, for the global peace and unselfishness. And all of the values that has to be cared accordingly to the human kind. So this is the thing, these are the messages that what we can, by which tools we can got the democracy. What is the meaning of democracy? There is here that democracy is not meaning that everybody is doing and giving the votes. There is democracy according to them is that there is, when there is no harmony, no peace, there can no any democracy can be exist. Peace in Gandhian philosophies, according to that is, Gandhiji has becoming a source of inspiration, not only for the nation, but for the entire world. Because when they have done for the humankind, for the personalities, for the persons, for the weaker section, for the poor persons, what has happened there? That they have become inspiration, not for the nation, but for the entire world. He inspired the world with his faith in truth and justice for all. Listen, students, if we think that this truth and justice, is it simple thing? No. We can say these are the weapons, these are the tools. If we follow, that is justice. Justice is not a very, very, very easy task. For giving the justice in a simple word, in a simple task, we have to make the efforts. We have to do work for that. So, they inspired the world with his faith in truth and justice for all men. Communal harmony had the pride of place in Gandhiji's constructive programs. Hoping that everyone seeks a world of love of unity, he's a great personage whose teachings will be enable humanity to build a new world. Communal harmony. Gandhiji is discussing about the communal harmony had to the pride of place in Gandhi's constructive program. These are the constructive programs that has been given by the Gandhiji's, by the communal harmony. What we have to done, they have done for that? They have made the harmony between each other of the persons by making that faith to each other. They have made that nation is first. They have made that truth. They have made that justice. We have to be able to give justice to everybody. He is a great personage whose teachings will enable humanity to build a new world. Influences of Gandhian philosophy. What is the influence has been seen of the Gandhian philosophy? That is, two out of the four pillars of education suggested by the Taylor's report, namely learning to live together and learning to be, are related to peaceful living. Dr. Martin Luther King and Dr. Nelson Mandela was greatly influenced by Gandhi's principle. President Obama is also impressed. National Curriculum Framework, NCF 2005 by NCERT, assert that education must be able to promote values that foster peace, humanness, and tolerance in a multicultural society. This is the framework has been drafted that Gandhian philosophy should be asserts that education must be able to promote values. What if the education should be there? That they promote the values that foster peace, make the humanness and tolerance in the multicultural society. What is here? That multicultural society, it means that all of the world, there is no differences between that, that every, that is Nelson Mandela, Martin Luther King, and there is also Obama. These all of the things that NCERT also asserts that education must be promoted by, education should promote the values. So all of these things that the Gandhian philosophy, these are the pillars of the education suggested by the Taylor's report. These things, that peace and harmony can be achieved by integrated effort. Integrated effort, by making the integration, we can achieve the peace and harmony. Actualizing students' potentials, teaching students how to learn and unlearn about life, helping them make peace with themselves and others. Live in harmony, help in dealing with the conflict, destruction and prejudice. These are the things that peace and harmony can be achieved by integrated effort. These are the things that live in harmony, make the peace to everybody, learn about the life, helping. This is a thing that help in dealing with conflict. These are the things that everything can be achieved. The thing is here that promoting peace and harmony for world peace and harmony. We have to develop common culture and attitude among global people. Initiative of peace to be taken up by all stakeholders, educators and psychologists, religious and spiritual leaders, administrators and legislators, parents and students. What type of promoting peace and harmony? For making the world peace and harmony, who will be the role players? Here, there is a common culture and attitude among global people. We have to start, we have to give in the initiatives for which? For the peace. Who will take the step, who will take, there will be the person that who will start the efforts, there are starting with that, that is stakeholders, who will be there, educators also, who will be the role players in promoting peace and harmony for world peace and harmony? This is the psychologist. These are the person, religious and spiritual leaders also, they have to do the duty accordingly to promote peace and harmony. And spiritual leaders there, and administrators and legislators, they have to make the rules and regulations accordingly. They have to administration, start the administration accordingly to peace and harmony for the world peace. And last but not least, there is a person, that is parents and students. These are the pillars who can start the promoting peace and harmony, from because they are the person that belongs to society, and society becomes a nation, and nation becomes the globe. So if we say that we there are the role players that who will do work for the peaceful harmony. So these are the person that role players in promoting peace and harmony for world peace and harmony. So students, there is spiritual leaders, administrators, legislature, parents, students have to be role players for promoting peace and harmony. This is here what will be done by the peace education. The word peace is mostly used in narrow sense to mean absence of war. It should mean not only absence of war, but violence in all forms such as conflict, threat to life, social degradation. Yes, there is thing that this word has been used in a narrow sense. We can say this is absence of war. But it should not meet on not only to absence of war, but violence in all forms such as conflict, threat to life, social degradation, discrimination, oppression, exploitation, poverty, injustice, and so on. The word peace should be, but there, if we say that that word should not be treated as a sense of war, but violence in all forms such as conflict, threat to life, and social degradation, discrimination, oppression, exploitation, poverty, injustice, and so on. So this peace word also count in these absences. Peace cannot be built as long as violent social structures exist in the society. Simple is there that if there is violent social structure exist, remain in the society, that peace cannot be bring. Naturally, such structures will lead people to act violently. Because if the society is working for the violence, that they will also lead the peoples to act violent. For instance, an unfair system of resources distribution in a society leads to frustration of those who get less. Frustration leads people to violence. Absence of all such unhelpful factors to a good life can be called negative peace. This is the example that if a person, an unfair system of resources distribution in a society leads to frustration. If a person is not getting according to his right, he will lead to frustration. And frustration leads people to violence. What they will do? They will become the violent. Absence of all such unhelpful factors to a good life can be called negative peace. Presence of happiness, health, content, and good economy, social justice, and freedom for expression, creativity, and support of personal growth at all levels are element of peace. It could be named as positive peace. There is, we have also taken negative peace, and here is positive peace. What is the negative peace is here? That this type of frustration, exploitation, oppressions, discrimination, social degradation, threat to life, conflict, violence, violent persons, these are the things that make the society in a negative peace. And here, happiness, when there is a society remains with the presence of happiness, health is moreover satisfactory, content and good economy, social justice is there, and freedom for expression, creativity, and support for personal growth at all levels are elements of peace. It could be named as positive peace. Inner peace, social peace, basic sources of peace within nature. This is here that inner peace, social peace, basic sources of peace within nature. Because if we say that peace should be bring out, So if we say that inner peace should be here, the social peace will come after that. So this is the basic source, peace with nature. Inner peace is peace with self. One whose mind remains calm in the middle of the sorrows, whose thirst for pleasure has altogether disappeared, and who is free from passion, fear and anger, is said to have achieved inner peace. Yes. If you say according to harmony and peace, the ideology of Gandhiji, if we start for gaining the peace, what do we have to do? That our mind has remains calm and calm middle of sorrows, whose thirst for pleasure has altogether disappeared, who is free from passion, fear and anger, said to have achieved inner peace. For example, harmony and peace with oneself, good health, absence of inner conflicts, joy, sense of freedom, insight, spiritual peace, feeling of kindness, compassion and content, appreciation of art. These are the things that by all of these things we can bring out, we can feel, we can support the peace, the inner peace. This is the thing that we can got the inner peace, and this way goes the inner peace way goes to society peace, social peace. What is the meaning? We can say the social peace is learning to live together. There is, for example, peace between man and man, harmony arising from human relationships at all levels, conflict, compromise and resolution, love, friendship, unity, mutual understanding, acceptance, cooperation, brotherhood, tolerance of differences, democracy, community building, human rights and morality. These are the social peace. What? Learning to live together. By this thing, how we can learn to live together? So what we have to make the social peace? Peace between man and man. What we have to do? That there should be a beautiful relationship between man to man. Harmony arising from human relationship. Harmony should be there in a humans, man person to person, they are related. Conflict. If a conflict arises, that there should be compromise and there should be resolutions also. There should be a relationship, good relationship with the harmony, friendship with each other, and unity. We have not to think only for yourself. We have to think about the unity. We have to think for the persons, the humankind, the mankind. Mutual understanding. No any comments between each other, no any aspects of selfishness between each other. There should be a mutual understanding. Acceptance. What type of acceptance is there? That I am with you, we are here. So this is type of acceptance. We are made for the society. We are for the society. We are for the nation. This is the acceptance. Cooperation. Every time ready to work for the humanity. This is cooperation. This is the brotherhood. Tolerance of differences. And there is a difference. What type of differences? That cultural differences, religion differences, and all type of differences that deal with the person. This tolerance of differences here. What type of differences we can say? When there is something is not accordingly to the society, to the unity. So there is tolerance of differences is here. Democracy. We can say that any country is not enjoying that type of democratic system. So when there is a democracy, we have to be a tolerance of power of the differences. Community building. Every effort should be work for the harmony and for the human relationship, for the humankind. So community building will be happened when we think about the relationship with the conflict, compromises and resolutions. With a mutual understanding, this is the community building will be started. The human rights and morality. If we think about the rights, if we think work for the rights, we give the rights to everybody, that is the human rights will start. And everybody is becoming the learning to live together. So this is the morality also. Morality is the main values according to Gandhi, that they have think about what should be the resources of morality. Morality is not a simple word. It is related with the all of the peace between man and man, relationship between all of the levels, mutual understanding, acceptance, cooperation. These are the morality that everybody has to face. So social peace is the thing that we have to start for learning to live together. This is the thing. Planet Earth is a cradle of human civilization. Symbolically, she is the Mother Earth. Peace with nature implies stopping the violation of our dignity through environmental and ecological degradation. There is also to be added here that if we want a social peace, we want the inner peace, we want the human peace, this is related to peace education. So this all things not to be that we have inner peace, we have not the social peace. We should be behaved like for the social peace also. So with this learning to live together is not for the humanity, for the peace between man to man, conflict, compromising, acceptance, mutual understanding, tolerance of differences. But it is also based on what we have done with the nature. This is the thing, that social peace is related with the planet of Earth, and that is planet peace can be covered here. This is planet, this is Earth peace. So this is the cradle of human civilization. What they have done, this is the planet of Earth, planet, and we can say Earth is the human cradle of the human civilization. What they have done, symbolically, we can say Mother Earth. Peace with nature implies stopping the violation of Earth. What we have to do, that we have to stop. What we implies, we have to stop the violation of our dignity, that and for the environmental and ecological degradation, exploitation. So we can say that is there is example also, harmony with the natural environment and Mother Earth. What we have to do, there should be a social peace. Learning to live together should be combined with the harmony with the natural environment and the Mother Earth also. Because when there is no harmony with the nature, environment and Mother Earth, what will happen? Our humanity, our human mankind, our democracy, our cooperation, brotherhood, everything will be lost. Because when there is a not harmony with the natural environment, and we have to stop the employ the violation with the Earth. So this is also to be commented here, that harmony with natural environment, that is Mother Earth, should be included here. We have to be convert, we have to make a promise with the social peace, inner peace, and for getting the harmony and peace with the natural environment and Mother Earth also. Peace is a behavior that encourages harmony in the way of people talk, listen, and interact with each other. This is discourage action to hurt, harm, or destroy each other. It should be also be globally relevant. This is really happens here. The social and cultural context and the needs of country. This is globally relevant here. In a country, the needs of cultural context. It should be embraced by its cultural and spiritual values together with the universal values. Peace education is a skill building. What we can say, there is also, peace education is a remedial measure to protect children from falling into the ways of violence in society. It aims at total development of the child. It tries to inculcate higher education and human values in the mind of the child. It attempts to develop a set of behavioral skills necessary for peaceful living and peaceful building, from which the whole of the humanity will benefit. Peace and education are inseparable aspects of civilization. There is also an interdisciplinary subject. This is peace education. This is also to help students develop knowledge and understanding of. So for the today, this is okay. Now this is the ending of this human values. Okay, thank you.